guys to be hurried and sit down, we appreciate it. I'm gonna move pretty quickly, I think all that Hudson table, I can point out for my table, take it away. Y'all, just a couple of things briefly, and then I have a proclamation that I'd like to present. But just to think for a minute, I would invite everybody here to pull out a copy of the words to the Star Spangled Banner and read them. Because we sing that so often that we often forget what it's all about. But it just got me proud of it. That was Francis Scott Key, who died on board a British ship in the harbor in Boston, where was it? Boston Harbor. Fort McHenry, which was an American fort, was being bombarded by the British. And when he asked the question, of course, there's two questions I mean. But he starts off talking about how they saw the flag up there, and they're wondering if it's still there, the American flag is still flying. And as the bombs burst, throughout the night, they can see it's still up there. And then he goes on to say that he got up in the morning and didn't get up, but in the morning daylight, it was still there. And then he asks the final question, which is, does that flag still wave over the land of the free and the home of the brave? It's a very strong question, and it's a good one to contemplate. I think sometimes we're that many people saw society a lot more clearly than we see it today. We get mixed up sometimes. But one thing, it's in our society that we've got to get rid of is this domestic violence. And I know that a lot of people in this room have been dedicated to it for a long time. I'm confident, I mean, you know, into all of in the room. I know there's some people who have been victims of it. And we probably haven't told anybody about it. This is a different kind of crime. As we know, this is not like most crimes. Let me start off saying, our people in this state are great. There's not another state that has the kind of people, the mixture of people that we do. And in my count, there are about 9 or 10 European countries that have people, immigrants who came over here. There are about 25 African countries, West African people came over here. Of course, they came over with slaves, you know. And also, when the Europeans got here, we called them Indians back then, and Native Americans more now. But there are about 40 tribes in South Carolina, way back, on all of them. So very few other states even come close to all those kinds of people. And we've been through everything over the years, from wars to hurricanes to floods, some recent, but we've been through everything in New York. So we've seen it all, and we're strong. But there's always going to be an element of criminal activity. I need to tell you, these big companies that I talk to as Lieutenant Governor and Governor there, they say it's the people of South Carolina that are different from any in the United States. They say South Carolina is a handshake state. If somebody gives you their word in South Carolina, they keep it. And that's why you see all these companies, the big ones, the people from outside of this place who look at us and say, I want to go to work, I want to invest a few $100 million or $1 billion in that state. It's always because of the people. But even as promising as we are, we're always going to have crime and discomfort and tragedies. Right? And that's what the Ten Commandments are called, is to try to keep us from doing that. We know it's going to still be here. But one crime is unique, and that is domestic violence. General Wilson, Environmental Statistics Director, this is a crime, it's hard enough to prosecute a crime. You have to have the evidence, or first you have to arrest the defendant, then you have to have evidence to get indicted or charged. Then you got to pull a jury, they might turn them loose, and you have to deal with the judge, then you have the appeals, and so a lot of crimes come through the punishment. But especially this one, because as I recall, it takes about a woman to be beaten about 10 times or more before she would call the law, because of the nature of this crime. And then when she gets to the courthouse, oftentimes she'll decide after seeing where's her boyfriend or whoever it is that was beaten, somebody that she knows, changes her mind for all kinds of reasons. So this was different. This was different from all the rest. and it destroys homes, and it ruins children, and life is tough enough for some people, but have your home be in the most violent place that you can exist, and more violent than walking out in the street. To have that as a place to grow up, it really makes it tough. But this is also a type of crime that can be combated by one main thing, and that is awareness. So let everyone know that it's going on, it happens, it's going to keep on happening, you should not be ashamed. People that want help, you're not alone, and if we prosecute forcefully, if we see something and we say something, if you know somebody in the street, tell somebody in authority. This is one where awareness can make a very big difference, probably the most dramatic difference of all. So that's why Peggy and I have to be here today. And if I may, I have a proclamation. State of South Carolina, Governor's Proclamation. Whereas the crime of domestic violence violates a person's privacy, dignity, security, and humanity through the systematic use of physical, sexual, and or psychological assault or abuse in order to exert control over that individual. And whereas, according to the Violence Policy Center's report on 2015 homicides, South Carolina is ranked fifth in the nation of the number of women killed by men, with 91% of female victims murdered by someone they knew, 72% of those victims being the wife, common-law wife, ex-wife, or girlfriend of the defendant. And whereas the effects of domestic violence on children can be devastating, causing depression and psychological distress, and raising the likelihood of physical violence among those who witness it, as well as continuation of the generational cycles of domestic abuse in the Panama State. And whereas the Domestic Violence Task Force of South Carolina was established in 2015 to study and address the cultural issues surrounding domestic violence in our state. And whereas Domestic Violence Awareness Month calls attention to the importance and advantages of working together to eliminate the blight of fear, violence, threat of violence from the culture and promise of our people. Now, therefore, I, Henry McMaster, Governor of the great state of South Carolina, do hereby proclaim October 2017 as Domestic Violence Awareness Month throughout the state, and encourage all South Carolinians to join together in the campaign to understand and eliminate domestic violence while comforting and encouraging its victims, letting them know that help is here and that they are not only signed by me, Governor of the State of South Carolina, Ms. Hudson, will you accept this, please?